Trump deep state conspired to prevent my presidency. President Trump alleged on Sunday that deep state agents within the FBI and DOJ conspired to prevent him from becoming president. Quoting Fox and Friends, Trump tweeted, "Seems like the Department of Justice, and FBI, had a program to keep Donald Trump from becoming president." Adair Alyssa at Fox and Friends, "If this had happened to the other side, everybody involved would be in jail. This is a media cover-up of the biggest story of our time." Newsmax.com reports, he also quoted Fox TV host Judge Jeanine Pirro. On Saturday, Trump accused his own attorney general of being scared stiff and missing in action as the president continued to question whether officials in his administration have acted appropriately in probing the Trump campaign's Russian connections. The big story that the fake news media refuses to report is lowlife Christopher Steele's many meetings with Deputy A.G. Bruce Orr and Orr's wife Nellie, Trump tweeted on Saturday, referring to former British spy Steele, who wrote a dossier alleging the Trump campaign conspired with Russia during the 2016 election. Trump said Nellie Orr, whose name he misspelled as Nellie, works for Fusion GPS, the research firm that hired Steele to compile the dossier. "I have never seen anything so rigged in my life. Our AG is scared stiff and missing in action. It is all starting to be revealed not pretty," the president said. Witch hunt. Trump has said repeatedly that Steele's findings prompted the inquiry that led to Mueller's investigation, but a congressional report found it began months earlier, following a tip about George Papadopoulos, one of Trump's political advisors. Scapegoating sessions. Saturday's comments by Trump appear to be responding to a statement by the conservative watchdog group Judicial Watch, which said it was suing the Justice Department for records of communications involving Orr, his wife, Steele and Fusion GPS. Trump has repeatedly criticized Attorney General Jeff Sessions, a former Republican senator from Alabama, who recused himself from special counsel Robert Mueller's probe into Russian meddling in the election. "Sessions should stop this rigged witch hunt now," Trump tweeted on August 1. Earlier on Saturday, on a rainy day at his New Jersey golf course, Trump said he may intervene to force the Federal Bureau of Investigation to turn over to Judicial Watch text messages sent by former Deputy Director Andrew McCabe. "Why isn't the FBI giving Andrew McCabe text messages to Judicial Watch or appropriate governmental authorities?" Trump tweeted. "FBI said they won't give up even one. I may have to get involved. Do not destroy. What are they hiding? Clowns and losers." Washington-based Judicial Watch has also filed a lawsuit seeking text messages and emails of McCabe relating to his wife, a pediatric emergency physician who ran unsuccessfully for the Virginia State Senate in 2015. Conservative critics, including the president, have argued that because Jill McCabe accepted a campaign contribution from then-Virginia Governor Terry McAuliffe's Political Action Committee, McCabe should have recused himself from the investigation into Hillary Clinton's use of a private email server. McAuliffe is a longtime friend of Bill and Hillary Clinton. "McCabe's wife took big campaign dollars from Hillary people," Trump tweeted on Saturday. The president went on to ask if the FBI would ever recover its once stellar reputation. "So many of the great men and women of the FBI have been hurt by these clowns and losers," Trump said of McCabe, former FBI Director James Comey, and other former bureau officials. Trump's hobby horse. The actions of the former deputy director have become a frequent hobby horse for Trump, who's said he believes that the Justice Department's decision not to prosecute Clinton, while continuing to investigate potential meddling between his campaign and Russia, is evidence of institutional bias. Saturday's tweets came after Judicial Watch President Tom Fitton appeared on a Friday night episode of Fox News's Hannity to promote the case. "We're fighting the FBI over text messages for the corrupt FBI official Andrew McCabe," Fitton said. "The FBI doesn't want to turn over one text message to us." The Justice Department initially denied the Freedom of Information Act request by arguing that the requested search parameters for McCabe's communications, which included terms like email, Democrat and campaign, were too broad, according to a filing by Judicial Watch. The government also said text messages related to McCabe's wife would be shielded by personal privacy protections. Sessions fired McCabe earlier this year, days before his scheduled retirement, following months of public criticism of the FBI official by the president. Sessions said he took the action on the recommendation of FBI investigators who argued McCabe had been dishonest with Comey about his role in an October 2016 Wall Street Journal article on an FBI investigation into the Clinton Foundation. McCabe has said that he didn't mislead anyone about his actions